everyone, to another episode of AppSec 101. Today, we're going to be diving into the topic of what is DAST. DAST is Dynamic Application Security Testing. And with us today, I have a DAST expert on the line. It's Rick Smith. He is over our Fortify Web Inspect product, which is a dynamic application testing tool. So Rick, I'll hand it off to you, and maybe you can give us just a quick background about yourself, a little bit of an intro, and some of your experience.
Cool. Sounds good. Yeah, so my name's Rick Smith. I'm based in Chapin, South Carolina. So I came to Fortify about 7 years ago. Prior to that, I'd been involved in IT for about 20 years. So network integrations and network security side of things. Came into the Fortify organization, supporting our customers on using our products. And then 2 or 3 years ago, moved into product management. So yeah, now handling our dynamic application security testing products. So Web Inspect Enterprise, as well as our Fortify OnDemand customers who use those products as well.
Awesome. And Rick, to start things off, maybe we could just talk a little bit about the basics of DAST.
Sure. So yeah, DAST stands for Dynamic Application Security Testing, as was mentioned a moment ago. And with DAST solutions, we're actually testing running applications. So typically when you're testing for security vulnerabilities, there's two major ways of doing that. One is static application security testing. The other is DAST, static being an analysis of source code, dynamic being an analysis of the running application. So we focus on that running application with our Web Inspect products, everything in that kind of line. And that involves kind of performing a crawl of that application, which means you give us a URL for a web application or you give us an API endpoint. And we enumerate, we identify, you know, everything that is involved in that application. So if it's a website, you know, we crawl out the application, we follow the links, we identify parameters and inputs. And then the second phase is where we audit that application. So we start analyzing the application and looking for vulnerabilities. Kind of the common way to look at that phase is a pen tester in a box. So obviously you don't kind of have the human element that is involved with a pen tester where they can kind of see some of the more business logic types of things, but you're able to very rapidly scan large applications and many applications with a tool like Web Inspect or with any DAST tool and identify vulnerabilities. So it's all happening at kind of that network level. So, you know, over HTTP or HTTPS. So we're making requests, we see, you know, a response that comes back and we identify an input on that page. And then we send attacks where we try to elicit a response. Based off of that response, you know, we're able to identify a large count of vulnerabilities, everything from SQL injection to cross-site scripting to even things like, you know, weak cipher and more environmental types of problems.
So you touched a little bit on SAST and DAST and kind of the differences between the two. Maybe you could dive into that a little bit more and touch on the differences between SAST and DAST, but also maybe how they complement each other.
Sure. So yeah, the difference between SAST and DAST. So static application security testing is again, you know, focused on source code. So what happens there is, you know, we, and Fortify has products that support that. We pull in source code, we translate that source code to an intermediate model that sort of flattens it out, makes, you know, all different languages look like, you know, a similar structure. And then we're able to apply rules to identify vulnerabilities in that source code. So we apply a rule that's able to trace data flow through source code to identify, you know, different types of vulnerabilities, like I mentioned before, cross-site scripting, or SQL injection, or any of the, you know, thousands of vulnerabilities that that we're able to detect. The difference with dynamic is, you know, that we're actually looking at that running application. We're making a request to a web server that has, you know, it's typically a web application server, something like Tomcat or IIS, has an application that's running on it. We make a request and we get a response. And based off of that response, we do further requests or further analysis to identify vulnerabilities. They complement each other very well. Static analysis is really good at highlighting source code weaknesses. So things that may or may not be a vulnerability based off of the, you know, the context of the application in many ways. So you're going to get more results out of static analysis typically, because there's things, you know, behind the scenes that dynamic analysis can't see. You know, we're not going to typically see or do as good of a job on the back end of applications as static analysis can. But on the flip side, you know, the pros are that, you know, with dynamic analysis, we can see the front end and we can see the configuration and we can see environment. And those are things that typically static analysis aren't able to see. So there's a lot of overlap. You know, if you think about the Venn diagram, the overlap is fairly significant, but what's probably more significant are the areas where they do not overlap, where they complement each other very well. And so that's why we really believe that, you know, for sort of good, thorough application security testing, you need to be running, you know, some form of static analysis as well as some form of dynamic analysis. So you get a real good kind of understanding of the security posture of the application. And then, you know, there are other concerns that are out there. You know, static analysis, you're obviously not running that against, you know, applications that are running in production. You're running it against, you know, source code that may be, you know, promoted and published into production environments. Whereas dynamic analysis does give you that ability. So, like I said, there's a lot of overlap, but really the interesting parts are where they don't overlap and where they you know, very well complement each other.
So you mentioned a Venn diagram, and maybe let's dive into that a little bit more. Looking at the areas where SAST doesn't overlap with DAST, what are some things that are unique to DAST? And maybe you could touch on some of the pros of DAST and then maybe some of the cons as well. Like, what are some things that DAST maybe isn't capable of doing?
Yeah. So, you know, the classic area, the area that's really easy to explain and easy for customers to understand are things that involve the environment. So if it's, maybe it's weak cipher, it's SSL, you know, types of findings, those are areas that static analysis isn't going to typically be as good at protecting or as good at detecting, I should say, and that they, you know, they typically can't see that. There are obviously exceptions to that, and you can identify, you know, weak, you know, TLS algorithms and those types of things with static analysis, but it's more difficult to see that real environmental side of things with static analysis. So dynamic analysis tends to really shine in those areas. It's also, you know, in a lot of ways, there's going to be less noise just by virtue of the fact that what dynamic analysis is doing is behaving or analyzing the application in a very similar way as a human would analyze an application. So if you think, you know, about the use case, we're trying to protect applications from an attacker exploiting a vulnerability. Well, dynamic analysis works much more similarly to the way an attacker would attack an application, in that, you know, we are actually running in a browser. We are exercising that application and identifying things that are kind of the lower hanging fruit in some cases, and sometimes they're not, but we're identifying those things that a human would actually be able to see. Whereas with static analysis, there's, you know, that context isn't quite the same. Static analysis is going to basically, you know, detect any kind of weakness, any kind of data flow, whether it's actually surfaced to the user necessarily or not. So there's, you know, there's strengths and weaknesses there. There's also some, you know, some strengths on dynamic analysis around API security, in particular when you start thinking about microservices and the way different services will interact with one another. Dynamic analysis is, with some of the, you know, more recent innovations, has actually gotten pretty good at, you know, kind of modeling those APIs. And understanding that, you know, input A is, or output A is passed into input B in, you know, disparate APIs. So there's some strengths there. You know, and probably the last strength is that, you know, we don't have to really know a whole lot about the source code that's being built or that the application is being built in. You know, it's the application is built and then, you know, deployed and presented via a runtime environment in most situations. It's something that any browser can sort of consume and render to a user. And sort of the way, you know, the way I sort of frame it with customers is if a browser can view it, if a browser can return it and render it to you know, a human, then we should be able to scan it. So in almost all situations, that's the case. And so that's, you know, one of the weaknesses of static is that you do have to understand the syntax of the language you have to understand the various code constructs. Dynamic doesn't have that same requirement. We're able to just see the application kind of in the way that a browser would see it.
Yeah, and I think that's a good point that you touched on, because sometimes to fully secure an application, you need to think the way that a hacker would. Mm-hmm. And so it makes sense that you would want to kind of attack it from the outside in, so to speak.
If you're prioritizing vulnerabilities, which is kind of the name of the game, you know, it's prioritizing what you're working on. We know that, you know, all teams can't remediate every single finding. So if you're looking for the things that you should, you know, probably focus the most resources on, in many situations, those will turn out to be the things that a dynamic tool can detect for you. And then, you know, and then you look at things by criticality. So there's all kinds of different ways to measure that and to prioritize. But you know, focusing on things that a dynamic tool can see makes a lot of sense, because those are going to be the same things that an attacker is able to see in many cases.
And Rick, one thing that I think all security professionals can agree on is, you know, they know security is important. They know they need to be testing. But one of the reasons that people maybe don't test as often as they should is because it can be time consuming. So maybe what's something that you would say to them as far as, you know, the importance of running regular tests, and why should security professionals be using tools such as DAST?
Yeah, that's a good question. And things have changed a lot. You know, what we're seeing is that our customers are no longer using DAST tools to run a scan of a single application or a handful of applications, you know, just a few times a year. They've actually got hundreds of applications, and they've still got, you know, two or three security folks in their organizations, which makes it even more important, because they don't, you know, we don't have that same ratio, or we don't have a better ratio of security testers to applications. Now we've got a lot more applications. So it's important to lean on the tool and to make sure that you're tuning it and make sure that it's kind of doing a good job for you. So DAST tools actually fit in really well there. You know, we know that teams don't have, you know, enough pen testers to cover all their applications. So the model that we're really seeing that customers are trying to move towards is more of a holistic model, where they're doing static analysis early. They're doing that often. They're identifying vulnerabilities soon as a part of their dev process, and they're remediating those as they work. And then they're using dynamic tools as well. So they're, you know, integrating dynamic tools into their pipelines as well, so that they're getting, you know, repeated scans, and they're not having to run these sort of ad hoc scans that, you know, save up vulnerabilities till release time, and then you've got this big panic sort of at the end. So it's really, you know, the combination of those two that we're seeing is really working for customers, and more customers are moving towards, you know, figuring out how to get things automated, making sure they're scanning what matters, making sure they're getting as much early feedback as they possibly can, and getting that into the hands of their developers who can, you know, actually remediate those findings, versus, you know, saving that, you know, till the end, where it just causes a, you know, a lot of friction in their programs.
Well, let's talk for a minute about the future of DAST and maybe where you see DAST going in the next couple of years.
Sure. Yeah, I think it's, you know, I think it's a lot of that holistic application security, which is what we've really seen from our customers, where we really see the industry going. And it's, you know, it's about getting testing integrated, you know, into pipelines, so that, you know, there's as little human interaction as possible, so that you can really focus your time on remediating findings. So where we really see this going is that customers are spending much less time configuring tools and configuring scans and all those types of things, and they're spending more time on actually remediating findings. So that's a, you know, that's a very, very strong theme in the AppSec industry. It's all around automation. How can you make things easier? How can you make things more accurate also? So there's a lot of things that we're looking at in terms of improving accuracy. We're fortunate that dynamic application security testing tends to be very accurate, but anything we can do to kind of reduce some of that noise is a big deal. Other kind of themes that we're seeing is, you know, it's not only about automation, but it's also about integrating into the existing tools that exist, you know, that teams are using, whether that's, you know, in QA, using things like Selenium scripts that are already there that teams are using for doing functional testing, and using those to drive dynamic tests also. So you get these really focused, really fast kind of CI/CD friendly scans, or integrating into things like OpenAPI that that teams are using to define or to document their APIs. That gives us good kind of a good surface area for a dynamic scan, or even things like Postman integration. So we're really seeing a lot of that. That integration story is becoming more and more important because it makes it easier to automate, and it reduces a lot of the manual efforts that have, you know, been that have typically existed for folks who are running dynamic application security testing programs. So a lot of automation, a lot of integration, and as you mentioned earlier, kind of getting it integrated and doing it as early in the process as possible.
Well, Rick, maybe to wrap up, you're the product manager for Fortify Web Inspect and also Fortify OnDemand. Maybe you could touch on how these products kind of solve some of these use cases that you've mentioned and how they help meet the needs of security professionals when they're doing this type of testing.
Sure. So yeah, Fortify OnDemand uses our dynamic application security testing product. So it uses Web Inspect as well as some other kind of in-house developed tools, but primarily the primary engine that's used in Fortify OnDemand is Web Inspect. So we run thousands of dynamic scans against customer applications. What Fortify OnDemand adds to the Web Inspect scan is an expert user of Web Inspect and an application security specialist who configures that scan and is able to then interpret results and remove false positives and make sure that the scan is tuned properly. So it kind of closes some of that people gap that we've seen, lots and lots of our customers, both small and large, have in terms of having the right resources to run scans. It's a really good solution for getting results very, very rapidly. You don't have to install anything. You don't have to know the product. You basically just have to provide us with a URL. So Fortify OnDemand really, really benefits there. And then, in the other direction, Fortify OnDemand actually benefits Web Inspect because we've got feedback loops that are sort of established that benefit our on-prem customers, and that, features and functionality and tuning and accuracy is all improved because we've got some of the best application security testers in the world running the tools and providing us feedback and telling us when we've messed up, when there's a bug, when we're flagging things that are not real, those types of things. So we're able to improve the product. So that sort of symbiotic relationship worked really well. That sort of feedback loop has worked really well. And the tools are really good at flagging those vulnerabilities, providing customers with the details that they need to secure their applications. That's the name of the game, and that's fundamentally what they're here for, is to make it easy for a customer to scan an application and to identify vulnerabilities and remediate them and to secure those applications. So we definitely try to make that as easy and as painless of a process as possible. There's definitely always room for improvement. We're always working to sharpen the blade there and to make things even better and better. But we do think the tools do a really good job of providing that level of feedback that customers need to secure their applications and to secure their programs.
Well, Rick, I appreciate you taking some time to speak with me today and to talk a little bit about DAST and why it's important. And, to our viewers, if you have any questions, please feel free to comment below. And we look forward to seeing you in another episode of AppSec 101. Thanks.
Thank you.